Previously on the Steve Saga. Guys, it's a Diamond Steve. We are from a village way across the other side, on the other side of the tundra. I'm sure you guys haven't explored that far, right? So would you mind leading us to your village? Fine. Okay. Well, guys, looks like we finally found a solution to our problem. We'll follow you, Diamond Steve. Right behind you. Villains aren't always so obviously cut and dry. Sometimes, it isn't simply just an evil-looking monster that hates all things good deep down to the bone. Things can be complicated. All the more reason for me to find my friends. That's right. The gang's getting back together. Cause, well, this is the Steve Saga. Well, we've been walking for a while, guys. It's getting nighttime. You think this Diamond Steve's actually taking us to his village?
I mean, I hope. I don't know where else he could really take us. He doesn't seem like he wants to hurt us or anything.
That is true.
Yeah, I mean, it's either his village or a trap that will be our ultimate demise.
Okay, well, that makes me feel more comfortable, more cozy, Guardian. Oh my gosh, there's actually a village here, bro.
All right, the first one, the trap.
All right, Diamond Steve. Good. We see that you took us actually to your village, and in no way am I shocked about that, but you did say that we're not allowed to be seen by the Gold Steves here, and it looks like there's plenty of Gold Steve houses, so we need to go around the village so we don't get spotted, okay? Well, we're right behind you. I don't know how many Gold Steves there are, but sure, we're right behind you. Come on, Guardian. Guys, look at this village. It seems like it's actually a nice village.
Oh, he's going up here.
Oh, he's really going around. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, wow, he really wants to go around. Okay, go ahead. We're right behind you. Okay. Whoa, guys, look at that statue.
Oh, that's so cool.
That is very impressive.
All right, well, let's hope that we don't get spotted. Maybe we'll have another chance to be able to look at it closer. Wow, this Diamond Steve is really playing it safe. Look.
Yeah.
I mean, at least it's nighttime. Steve's probably sleeping, so we got a good chance right now. But if it becomes day out, then that's probably going to be pretty rough. Where's the Diamond Steve even taking us? Hey, Diamond Steve, where are you taking us anyways, man? If we can't be seen by the Gold... Ow. If we can't be seen by the Gold Steves, then where are we going? Because we're in the village. To my house. Oh. Okay. So we're going to go and hide inside of his house then. All right. Well, that sounds good, I guess.
I can assume it's that big diamond house we saw on the hill.
What big diamond? Oh, my gosh. That big diamond
house. Oh, that big one. Okay.
Hey, this kind of reminds me of the Overseer's village, right, Alex?
A little bit, yeah.
It's got a statue. I mean, it's not like a Steve statue. But... Yeah. Look, we can oversee the village from here, but we should probably hurry up and get inside, huh?
Yeah.
Okay,
don't need them seeing us.
So this is your house, Diamond Steve. Okay. All right. I see you, man. I got you. Looks like you got. What do you got here? You got a diamond on the wall. Sorry, I'll probably.
Why are you spinning stuff?
Hang on. Sorry.
No,
I got it.
Stop. Stop.
I was trying
stuff.
To make it. Ooh, right. Okay. My bad. Looks cozy, man. Looks like you got, man, it seems like these Steves don't really know how to decorate too well.
Maybe we should worry about that later and worry about the task at hand, which is...
Oh, he's got a pretty blue flower here. That's nice. That's pretty nice, right? Okay. Well, yeah, Diamond Steve, sorry. I should probably stay focused. My colleagues here were distracting me. We're wondering, Diamond Steve, if... I mean, you've already been gracious enough to take us into your home, and it seems like you got a nice, cute little village out here. With a cool statue, which reminds me, that statue looks like it's a blend of diamond and gold. Looks like it's a cool representation of, I mean, how your society even works. You got the gold and diamond working together to create something great. That's pretty cool, man. That's pretty deep. That's at least the way I interpreted it. How do you guys interpret it? Here, maybe take a look. Oh, I put my torch down. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, there we go. Go ahead and take a look. This is pretty important. All right, Alex, what do you interpret from the statue?
It's kind of like a symbol of them all coming together. It's very nice.
Yeah. Okay, Guardian, what do you think?
Statue.
All the things you guys said.
Wow, man. Okay.
That's so insightful.
That's deep. I can't even hear you. That was so deep. Okay. Okay. So,
the one thing I did notice about it, it looks like it has like a staircase or something spiraling around.
Oh, yeah. It does look like it has a little spiral. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, it sure does have something up top. So, we'll get back to that later. Either way, Diamond Steve, now that we are here and have your undivided attention, We are gonna rob you. Ah, I'm just kidding. Imagine though. I'm just kidding. We're not gonna rob you. Oh man, sorry. Bad timing. Bad timing.
Yeah. Is that really bad timing?
Yeah, yeah. We're not gonna rob you, man. Either way, we are going to need your assistance and your help on actually making what we need to do if we're gonna get rid of that lightning. Obviously, you can't hear it this far away, so that's pretty cool. But it's still happening. So what we gotta do is we've gotta make a machine. I don't know if your people have ever made one before, but we could definitely use your help. It's actually a bit ironic. I guess you can hear the lightning from here. Okay. It's actually a bit ironic though, because coincidentally, the machines that I make to fix problems like the lightning happening use and require large amounts of gold and diamond. Would you look at that? What a weird coincidence, right, guys?
Yeah, that's sure is strange how things work out like that.
Yep. So if you'd be so willing as to possibly give us just stacks of gold and diamond blocks, I'm not sure. I still don't trust you. Well, you've already let us into your home, your most private place of living. So how much more do we need you to trust us, man? Think about it. I mean, we literally already have... Wow, nice diamond armor, man. You really have a lot of cool diamond stuff here, I gotta say. Diamond Steve's you guys must be living just good. You make diamond pickaxes, make diamond swords, diamond axes, diamond shovels, everything. You make diamond everything. Diamond armor must be living easy, huh? But you know who isn't living easy? The people in the other villages who have to deal with that lightning. The lightning's spreading, and it's a danger to all of us, even your people eventually. If it gets any worse than it is now, then even if you guys can make things out of diamond and gold, it's not gonna protect you. Think about it. That lightning shows that there's some kind of tear in this world. I mean, if we don't fix it, then it could get worse, man. We're gonna need your help to fix it. You think you can do it? I'm sure your people are scared. When they sleep at night and they hear that lightning, they're not sure what could happen. You're right. Oh.
Oh, okay. I guess we're following.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Case?
Hey, Diamond Steve, what do you got on your mind, man? These Steves need to stay safe to get stronger and be Diamond Steves. Yeah, that is, that's pretty true. If you think about it, Gold Steves, they have so much potential. And if you want them to be able to grow and become as strong as you are, then they need to have bright futures. And in order to do that, you're probably gonna have to need some help. It's either them or you ask us. You could get those Gold Steves to help you, but they have no idea what's happening. We've been investigating this the entire time, and it's been our jobs from the other villages on the other side of the ice tundra that we come from 100% to fix it. So what do you say, man?
As he said, we're not exactly like the other Steves, I suppose. So the Gold Steves, our presence might alarm them.
That is true. We would probably terrify them. That other Gold Steve that we ran into on the outpost that was keeping track of the lightning, he's probably so desensitized that we didn't scare him. But then again, he also didn't trust us. He didn't really want to talk to us. He seemed pretty annoyed just in general. I'm guessing just the whole situation was putting him off. Maybe... No, that would be crazy. Maybe what? Maybe what?
What? Come on.
You can't just say that, man. You already started. You know the rules, man. Okay? You have to just say it now. Okay? Come on. If there's...
Is that a rule?
Yeah, yeah, it's the rule. If you're like, hey, wait a second. Nah, I can't do that. Then you're just, come on. You already threw the hook out there. You got me on the hook, man.
Everybody knows that, Alex. You can't just say something like that and not follow through.
Yeah, see, even Guardian knows that's the rules, man.
I feel out of the loop. I apologize.
It's okay. Now you've learned, and now you just, in the future, if you say something like that, that's the rule. You gotta just follow through. So, come on, Diamond Steve. If there's a way to possibly help us, if there was a way that you could supply us with a bunch of diamonds and maybe even gold, then I could make us a machine, something that'll be able to suppress that lightning, something that'll be able to keep you guys completely safe. So, what do you say? Do you have something that could save us? I'm not sure. We haven't used it for a long time. Well, this is probably a better time than never. It's gonna become day out soon. We've been traveling all throughout the night. And when it does become day, Alex, me, and the Guardian are gonna have to stay hidden. And the longer that we stay hidden, the longer that lightning gets worse. We won't be able to do anything throughout the day, so we've gotta hurry up and take action now, or else it'll be too late. Once the sun rises, then The gold thieves will come out. They'll be wandering around living their lives. And if they even see us, it'll be game over. They're going to freak out and they won't let us be able to do anything. Especially if you say that you have something that we could work on. If they don't know about it either, then this could be a big problem. So what do you say? You willing to give us a chance? We've already come this far. And I can tell that you're pretty worried about that lightning. That gold thief that we left at the outpost isn't really helping you, but you having to check on him did find us. So technically he did kind of do his job, actually, weirdly enough. Came full circle, so that's good. So what do you say? Come on, man. Really running out of time here. Sun's gonna rise. Well, okay, but I'm not sure if it still works. All right, well.
If what still works?
Yeah, that's a good point. If what still works, do you mind showing us or what? Why don't you just lead us to whatever you're talking about? Let me show you, okay? Wait, guys.
Yeah?
We'll be right with you, Diamond Steve.
Are you guys sure we should be using this Diamond Steve stuff? I told you guys that we can still probably find a way out of here without using these guys' help. We should just leave these guys alone. I'm telling you, this could end badly.
We're already this far, and he really does seem like he just wants to help.
If he's willing to help, and as you say, if us getting out of here can help them, it would be mutually beneficial.
All right. Let's do it. All right, Diamond Steve, what do you got to show us, man? Since no one is looking, I can show you this. Okay, so I'm guessing no one else knows about this then? What is it? Okay, he's breaking flowers. What?
Okay, he's digging into the ground.
There's a staircase. This looks like definitely no one else knows about this. Diamond Steve, I'm guessing we should go down. Okay. Well, guys, you ready?
Yeah. Sure, I'm ready.
I'll be right behind you. All right, let's go.